I will certainly look. I will keep an eye on the boxing game, 100%. I'll keep an eye on USBN News. All it will do for me is it'll give me more options, but my options will stay open. I may box, I may continue to fight in the UFC, but I certainly will do both. You know what I mean? Which is which, or which one next, all that type of stuff, I don't know, but I certainly will continue to do both.
Thank you. Happy birthday.
Connor, my name is Bob Harrison. How are you doing?
Very good. How are you?
How's the sparring going for you? You know, 10, 12 rounds, you feel after 4 or 5 rounds, you're hitting for everything. Guy's still there. Now these latter rounds, do you think, how do you feel you're doing the 10 and 12 rounds?
It's a 3-minute round, 2 minutes shorter than I'm used to. There's no up and down, there's no scrambles, there's no lifting the leg this height for kicks, there's no jumping through the air, there's no 360 spins, there's no clinch work against the fence, he's gonna feel like he's wrestling a bear when we tie up for the first time. You know what I mean? And he's going to be, like, no matter what, I come from a game where we grapple and he boxes, but what a human does under stress and fear, no matter what skill set they possess, they grab. That's just a human reaction. We grab and hold and try and, that's what they do. But when he tries to grab and hold me, he's not just grabbing and holding a boxer, he's grabbing and holding a serious specialist in the clinch. You know what I mean? You're talking, like, there's Greco-Roman wrestlers that, like, all they do is fight in the clinch. They can only attack the upper body. There's some, that's what I'm trying to say. Like, he just does not understand what he's in for. And he's not going to keep me off him. He is not going to keep me off him. He's too small. I'm going to have my way with him. So, that's where I'm coming from.
In the 10 to 12 rounds, like, they call it the dog rounds, do you feel like, you know, you're there, like, 10 to 12 rounds?
I will be prepared. I've been sparring 12. No problem.
Yeah.
Switching bodies. I bring them in. I have a referee also for spars. We were advised to bring a referee in so we can acclimatize to the rules. So how you know, certain details in the fight, what the ref flags and what the refs, you know what I mean? Just like that. So, and then I'm bringing people in and we're facing off. It's a fight. We're having fights in the gym. So I'm having a lot of solid boxing fights already. Behind closed doors. So I'll be ready. Make no mistake, I'll be ready. I will be ready for 12, but he's gone down in 4.
Thank you, Connor. Thank you. All right, Connor, here in the middle. Champ Creed, Fox Sports Radio. Your stance is more of a traditional karate, Jeet Kune Do stance, and you move very well north and south. Mm-hmm. Floyd, his elusiveness allows him to move east-west, and he tends to throw his opponents off balance before they can plant and throw the power shots. Mm-hmm. With your boxing training, in this such limited amount of time, how have you found a way to balance your energy with the movements that come with boxing as opposed to what you traditionally study for in MMA?
Yeah, a karate style is one of my stances. But I can stand many ways. I can attack many ways. I can attack from both stances. I can switch up, go from a from a karate stance to a taekwondo stance. I can go to a boxing stance. I can go to a Thai boxing stance. There's many different ways to stand in front of a man. And I know every shot he throws. I know what to expect. I've seen it before. He does the same stuff over and over again. Similar to tonight, saying the same stuff over and over. So we're preparing. But him, he knows nothing. He knows absolutely nothing of what way I'm going to approach this fight and what way I'm going to come at him. So that's a beautiful position I am in. So I look forward to exploiting that and getting that knockout win.
All right, and the last thing is speak to your ability of visualization. MGM Grand, before you fought Dustin Poirier, a woman came up to you and said, "Hey, are you a fighter?" And you said, "Yes." And she said, "Did you fight Floyd Mayweather?" You said no, but I'm gonna knock him out like I'm gonna knock out Dustin, right? This was years ago. I see you about maybe 2 years later, and then you bring up the fact that you will be the king of Las Vegas. Someone in the crowd says, "But you gotta beat Floyd," and you said he can get it too. And now here we are.
Yeah.
Can you speak to the level of how you verbally speak these things and they come to exist? Where did you learn that trait to visualize these things?
I'll tell you, it's been one hell of a journey. It's been one hell of a journey. 4 years I'm signed to the UFC. I was able to rise up, capture the two gold belts, capture all the records, and now I'm facing the current number one guy in boxing. What a journey. I mean, I'm just blessed. As far as like visualizing it, I honestly feel like I can predict the future. If I see something in my head, I speak it out loud, I'll believe in it truly, and then it just happens. And it's been happening for me my whole career. And I guarantee August 26th on the night when we're sitting back here or backstage at the T-Mobile, you'll be asking me the same question, how do you do it? And I just see it, I speak it, and it happens, and that's it. I can't fully tell you why or how, but it's just, yeah.
You're gonna do it.
Yeah, sure.
You're gonna do it.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Okay, thanks so much, everyone.